Hi, this is Teddy from Switzerland with another knife review, and today we're going to take a look at a knife from Boker Plus, as you can see by the box on the table. And the one today is a really nice collaboration between Boker Plus and a very well regarded custom knife maker, and it's the Boker Plus Bullpup, which is a collaboration between Boker Plus and the custom knife maker Charles Marlowe, and it is based on his Bulldog model, which is a slightly larger version of practically the same exact design. So a very, very nice design in my opinion. There is also another Charles Marlowe Boker Plus collaboration that is called the Squale, which is a larger 4-inch bladed version with a thumb hole deployment, and also a different design, but it also sports the same handle configuration with the titanium bolster and the micarta handle. So really, really gorgeous design in my opinion. I really like what they did here in collaboration with Charles Marlowe, and they actually come very, very close to his Bulldog model. Charles Marlowe also did a collaboration with Benchmade knives with a model that is very similar to his Balisong. It's called the Benchmade 53. Also a pretty nice knife for a Balisong. I'm not a big fan of Balisongs, but I think that one looks really, really nice. So first, as always, we're going to take a look at the specs of this knife. So we have an overall length of 7.25 inches or 18.5 centimeters. That gives you a blade length of 3.25 inches or 8.3 centimeters, and a handle length of 4 inches or 10.2 centimeters. You also get a pretty thick blade stock of 0.15 inches or 3.8 millimeters, so really, really stout blade thickness here, which certainly is going to add to the weight as well. And you see, this knife is quite a compact knife from Boker Plus, but it fits my hand quite well. So I think really nice overall design in looks and also in ergonomics and functionality. Now let's take a look at the weight of the Boker Plus Bullpup. And this knife weighs 148 grams or 5.2 ounces, which is quite a stout weight for a blade that is only 3.25 inches long, but that of course is because it has a very, very stout blade stock, as you saw before. It also features titanium bolsters over quite thick steel liners, as you can see here, which are not skeletonized to save some weight. So the overall construction makes this knife a quite hefty one, but it really feels nice and substantial in your hand. So on this model, I really think the weight adds a little bit to the feel of the knife. It really feels more like a custom blade because of that. In my opinion, I think for this knife the heavier weight is quite suitable. Now let's take a closer look at the 3.25 inch long blade of the Boker Plus Bullpup, and you can see you have a very attractive clip point blade shape that you don't see on a lot of folding knives. You have this prominent swedge at the top and a hollow grind, which is of course the right decision in my opinion if you're dealing with a very thick blade stock, as we have here on the Bullpup. They also finish the blade in a very gorgeous slide stone wash, and you have your Boker Plus logo here on the primary bevel, and also the serial number here at the top. Mine happens to be number 814, and you also have very nice thumb studs, which really remind me of the thumb studs used in the Kershaw Blur. These really nice large and angled thumb studs, which work exceptionally well to deploying the blade. But on the Bullpup right here, they are only on the right side, so this is certainly a right-hander knife. And you also see you have jimping here at the top, on the liners, on the titanium bolster, and on the blade itself, which is quite functional jimping as well. But I really, really love the blade shape. You have a very large amount of belly here, and the very, very gorgeous swedge here at the top. So a blade shape that is really, really well done in my opinion. On the other side, you also have the marking of the custom knife maker Charles Marlowe with the turtle logo, and the marking of the steel that they're using, which is actually VG10, which Boker Plus is moving toward on more and more of their knives, switching away from the 440C that they used previously. And I think that is a really nice choice, because the VG10 is a premium Japanese cutlery steel that has good edge retention, very good corrosion resistance, and also a fine grain structure, so you can get a really nice razor's edge on it. And it's also a quite well-known and proven steel, because it is used in some Spyroco knives, for years now. Now let's take a closer look at the beautiful handle design and construction on the Boker Plus Bullpup, and this is really where the magic happens for me. You have a fantastic design with a bead blasted titanium bolster on both sides of the knife and a green micarta handle scale. They meet up really perfectly here. In the middle there are no detectable seams, just very well done. The whole knife is put together by polished torque screws with a large screw here at the pivot point, which really gives a nice contrast to the bead blasted titanium bolsters. And of course, because they are torx, you can take the knife apart if you have to. One other nice design feature is the cutout here on this side on the titanium bolsters, which allows you to get to your liner lock very easily and also provides a little bit of a finger choice when you're gripping the knife. Other than that, the fit and finish on this knife is really exceptional, and the micarta scales provide a nice amount of traction and feel very, very comfortable in hand. So really, really nice handle material choice. You don't see a lot of folding knives with micarta handle scales, and I'm really glad that they chose this here instead of a G10 or a carbon fiber. I really like the combination of materials here on the Bullpup. If you take a look here at the spine of the handle, you also can see the jimping again, and it is really nicely done on the bolster and also on the liners, and it's also perfectly matched up here on this side, but on the other side it's a little bit off, but not by much. And you can see the fit and finish of the handle scales and the bolsters to the steel liners is really flawless. Very, very well done. Half of the handle is closed by this aluminum backspacer that is anodized black, and I'm really glad that they use aluminum here and not the Zytel or some kind of cheap material. It really adds to the substantial and quality feel of this knife, and it's also fitted absolutely perfectly. Nothing is overstanding, everything fits very well. You can also peek inside here a little bit and you can see that the steel liners are not skeletonized. That is one thing that I really would have liked to see, if they skeletonized the liners to make it a little bit more lightweight, to get it under the 5 ounce limit. Maybe that would be a nice addition that they could do in a second run of these knives. If you switch the knife over to this side right here, you can take a look at the very interesting and short pocket clip, which reminds me a little bit of the pocket clips used on the Southern Grind knives that I have reviewed. These nice short stubby pocket clips, and one neat thing here is that the pocket clip ends on the titanium bolster, which is of course a smooth surface, so it's easy to get in and out of your pocket. But if you like to, you can switch it to a right-handed tip-up carry, but then of course you are dealing with the micarta, the rough micarta here, which certainly feels nice in hand, but it makes it a little bit harder to extract out of your pocket. You also have a lanyard hole, which is a little bit small for 550 paracord. I don't think that that is possible. Maybe gutted paracord, but I think a small leather lanyard or something like that should certainly fit through this hole. If you take a look at this view here, you can see the lockup here of the steel liner. They are very nice thick steel liners, which are also finished in some kind of bead blast finish, and the lockup is perfect, and there's also a lot of room to wear as well. So very, very well done. I love the handle design. It also feels quite ergonomic in my hand here. You can also go in a foregrip like this. So very well. Of course, it's a smaller knife, so it is certainly for smaller hands, but if you have smaller hands, it's a really nice handle design, because you can see here it's also a quite thick knife, so it's a really nice hand filling feel. Now let's take a look at the deployment and the action of the Boker Plus Bullpup, and that is also a strong suit of this knife, which I was really impressed of, because with this thumb stud you can really deploy this knife with absolute ease. It flicks out every time, and it's also very, very smooth, as you can see here. Really, really nicely executed knife here with a fantastic action and an absolute rock solid lockup. There's absolutely no play side to side, nothing up and down. Everything is as I got it right out of the box, so no lubing, nothing has been done to this knife. Just a perfect action in my opinion for a thumb stud deploying knife. And I really, really love the blur style thumb stud that they use here, and I also like that it is only one-sided. I always like these kind of knives that only have one thumb stud and didn't add something unnecessary for me personally, because I'm a right-handed person. So really nice action here, and also nearly a free-falling blade. They also used some high-quality washers in this blade. As you can see here, really nice bronze washers on both sides. Also very nice tolerance, as you can see here, the fit and finish on the materials. Just very, very well done. Here you can also take a look at the centering of the blade. Just perfection. I'm really, really impressed with the quality that they put forward here on the bullpup. This knife is also made in Taiwan and not in China, like a lot of the Boker Plus built knives. And I think that really shows that this is a really high quality example of a Boker Plus knife. So really nice action, fantastic fit and finish, perfect lockup, just a really, really nice knife with a fantastic design from Charles Marlowe, in my opinion. Now let's take a look at the sharpness of this knife. I now had it for over a month and carried it in my EDC rotation, and was very pleased with the performance of this knife. And it really is a razor sharp knife. It also came very, very sharp out of the box, and really impressive for a knife of this thickness. And I think the hollow grind really shows here its performance benefits. It just is a fantastic slicer and a very ergonomic and nice knife in hand as you're using it, if you have a little bit smaller hands. So really, really nice knife. Cuts this paper here like butter. Absolutely no problem for the bullpup here by Boker Plus. Very impressive performance for this knife, especially considering the blade thickness here. So they really did an absolutely fantastic job on the grinding of this knife. Just really, really well done in every aspect here on the Boker Plus Bullpup. Now let's come to the size comparisons I like to do. And the first I have for you is the Kershaw Injection. It is a Todd Rexford collaboration with Kershaw. Of course, this is a China-made knife with G10 handles and ACR13 MOE blade steel and a 3-inch long blade. So it's slightly smaller, but also very much smaller in this dimension right here. Also a very nice EDC knife, in my opinion. Here you can also see the thickness. The bullpup is quite a lot thicker here, and also in the blade stock and the handle thickness, than the injection. But of course, the injection is a little bit lighter here. You can also see the pocket clips and the difference right here. So really nice, budget-friendly knife here, the injection, designed by Todd Rexford. The next size comparison I have for you is an Italian knife, and it is the Lion Steel SR2A, which stands for the aluminum body that it has here instead of the titanium that is also available. And you can see here that these two knives are also quite similar in the overall size. The bullpup is a little bit longer here in the blade. They are also both very high quality knives, in my opinion. Here you have also quite a thick blade stock, as you can see here. 4 millimeters, 3.8, very, very comparable. But you can see that the bullpup is also thicker in the handle dimension right here than the integral designed SR2. If you put it like this, you can also compare the pocket clips. In this comparison, I would certainly go for the Lion Steel pocket clip, because it's just a deep carry and it's also black, and so a little bit more unobtrusive. But both of them are quite ergonomic knives, really nice blade shapes on both of them. The last size comparison I have for you is a knife that is made in the US, and it is the Southern Grind Spider Monkey. A fantastic knife, really, really gorgeous design, fantastic fit and finish, really placed in the realm of a mid-tech knife, in my opinion. You have fantastically designed carbon fiber handle scales, full titanium liners and lock, and the S35VN blade steel. And size-wise, it is really comparable here to the bullpup, as you can see right here. And I think this size is a very, very nice size for an EDC knife. But of course, it's going to be a lot lighter than the bullpup because of its construction. And in the thickness department, The bullpup is also going to be quite a bit thicker and more hand filling. But here, if you turn it around like this, you can also see the similarities in the pocket clip design. Both of them have stonewashed, stubby, short pocket clips. So, really, really nice. I really come to like these kind of pocket clips more and more. And this knife is just a fantastic, fantastic EDC knife. You can see here how well they finished the carbon fiber handle scales. Just one of the most perfect EDC knives, in my opinion. Very well done here, Southern Grind. And you saw here that I compared the bullpup to a lot of higher priced knives like the SR2 and the Spider Monkey you saw before. And that is because I think you really get here quality beyond its price point on the bullpup. I'm very impressed with what Boker Plus executed here in this collaboration with Charles Marlowe. Now let's talk about value and price and come to a final conclusion about this knife. So if you want to get yourself your own Boker Plus bullpup, you're gonna pay around $90 to $100 depending on where you get it. And as always, you're gonna find a link to my recommended retailer in the description box below. And I think for that amount of money, you really get a fantastic knife, which really performs out of its price range, in my opinion. You get fantastic handle materials and blade steel here on this knife. In this price range, you get micarta, which you don't see on a lot of knives these days, and they really executed it very, very well. You have nice titanium bolsters, which are fitted perfectly to the liners and to the handle material. You have the VG10 steel, which is a very nice, high quality steel, in my opinion. The quality of manufacturing is something that extremely surprised me here on this knife. It is really fantastically made. The centering is perfect, the lockup is perfect. It's a very, very smooth knife. They did use aluminum for the backspacer and not some cheap Zytel or anything like that. It really adds to the substantial feel and the quality feeling you get when you pick up your bullpup. The only one downside I may have is the weight, but I think in the overall design concept of this knife, with the short, stubby style of this knife, I think the weight is not that big of an issue. I really think if they just milled out the liner a little bit and brought it down under the 5 ounces, it would be absolutely perfect. Here it is a little bit on the heavier side, but I think it really fits with the theme of the overall design by Charles Marlowe, which really did a fantastic job. So overall, I can absolutely recommend the Boker Plus bullpup to you. If you have some kind of smaller hands, this knife will fit your hand perfectly. You have nice jimping. The overall design is just fantastic. And if you have a larger hand, take a look at the Boker Plus Squale, which unfortunately sports the 440C in the micarta handled version. There is also a G10 handled version that has VG10, but I think that takes away a little bit from the design if you lose the micarta. So overall, a fantastic, fantastic knife. Really highly recommended by me. I just love the overall design, and I think for the price that they're asking, they really deliver a lot of value, in my opinion. A fantastic knife, and I'm absolutely not sure why there is not a lot of hype or not a lot of coverage on this knife. Particularly, there is only one review on YouTube, as I have seen so far, and I hope I can get this knife the publicity that it really, really deserves. So this was my review of the Boker Plus Bullpup designed by Charles Marlowe, and I hope you liked it. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions about anything I talked about in the review, please leave it in the comments. I will try to answer you there. And if you want to see more of these knife, gun, and gear reviews, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.